Okay, so welcome back to my channel Voice Over Stitches, and today I'm gonna make a video which is a bit different from other videos that I have previously made. Now this video is particularly based on the game 1 of the tournament which I recently played, where that was the first Skillcraft Open in Delhi, and I played a total of 7 rounds there and score not a very good 3.5 points, but I played a few good games in the starting of the tournament. And I'm gonna show that all to you. Actually, I guess I noted only 5 of them. So I'll be showing 5 of the 7 games one by one in each video. So this video is all about the game 1. So let's get started. Okay, so coming on to the game 1. So I was paired actually with an unrated opponent named Madhav. And he was a 9-year-old kid. And as you all know who had already played tournaments, that 9-year-olds are actually very dangerous in chess tournaments, so I was a bit nervous about playing him, but it turned out to be not very difficult because you'll see what I'm talking about in the game. So let's start. So Madhav was white and I was black, so he opened up with d4 and as usual I responded with the Dutch defense f5. He went for the close version of this d4 queen's pawn opening, that is knight f3 instead of the usual c4 that is played. I played the simple knight f6, knight c3, e6, not going for the simple Dutch with g6. Sometimes I prefer to play e6, but sometimes also prefer to play this. Bishop f4, and now I went c6. Now I wanted to go into the setup of the Dutch Stonewall that I already also talked about in some of the previous videos. He unfortunately took here. So this was the first move when I realized that he's not that a strong opponent of me, and I can easily be trick him or win against him. I just took, and as you all see, that bar already prefers black. E3, D5, gaining that usual structure of the Stonewall, and Bishop E3, Bishop D3, Bishop B4, and white castles. Now here it already shows equal, because I guess the main advantage that I got was because he took the knight and I took the rook, so I needed to play something like B5, B4, or something active instead of just going into this line. I played knight e4, he took with the bishop, I took with the f pawn, and he went knight e1, which was a very surprising move, because I thought maybe knight d2 was a much better move, although knight d2 and knight b3 and knight fc5 or something, that is a long process. But after knight e1, I don't see a square for the knight, right? So that was the whole problem, but we'll see his plan. He went here, I castled, and he played f3, which was his plan. If I took, he took with the knight, which I actually took. The engine doesn't suggest us to take the pawn, but there was no idea how I could have found that, because I just thought that he would take it and I have to take back and something would happen. If I take, there's a doubled isolated pawn, so why not just undouble my pawns with taking that pawn. So I took that pawn, he took with the knight, b6, a3, and I brought my bishop back, so I had a double bishop advantage. So here I was in a dilemma, because I thought maybe I can take the knight and double his pawns and also isolate his pawn, but I thought that maybe he can go for c4 or something like that, and maybe I don't have advantage in that position. So I went for bishop d6, which is surprising that it's also the first engine suggestion move. He went for e4, and again I went for the best engine move, bishop a6, dragging the rook and gaining a tempo while developing my own bishop. Rook e1 and rook b7. Now here too, rook b7 is the best move. I don't know how I found the sequence of moves correctly according to the engine too. E takes d5, and I took the e pawn. He played b4, and here maybe I played not the best move. I played bishop c4. I thought maybe this was a good outpost for the bishop, but as you can see, the engine suggests rook bf7. Now this is the move I personally don't get, because I don't know how you would exchange this knight or move anyway bring an attack, because I don't think that this knight, like the defender, this defender of that is the knight can be removed in any way. But anyway, I went for bishop c4, rook b1. Again, he suggests, Ranjit simply suggests a rook f7 on every move with bf7. I went for b5, closing, I thought close the position, but he went for a4 and a6. He took, I took, and queen d2. Now the black position is much better, but it is only because I have a double bishop advantage, which I gained more in this move, that is bishop f4. He has to go back, and I brought rook e7, just exchanging one pair of rooks. He took, I took, queen, I brought the rook, takes, and he brought here, which was a blunder. Now here, I guess he had some chances. Actually, I have a double bishop in the endgame, so it's very difficult to create that many chances. But still, because these two squares are nicely guarded, I can't bring my rook into the game. So I have to maybe try bringing my rook from here, which is also very difficult. So I had to make some plans for pushing my pawns from this side and maybe attacking some pawns this way, somewhere or the other. But it was really a long process to take, but he simply blundered with this. I took, he took, and I play bishop d2, forcing both knights, and it's a simple double attack technique. And here, although the game didn't end, he played something like knight d3, I took, and the game went on, but it was an easy win for me. I converted it easily. So that was the first game. I won against Madhav, my first game, and as black. And in the second game also I won, which will be coming soon in the next video. So stay tuned and bye bye. Meet you in the next video. Thank you.